families and preschool students. This is Sarah Holokai. I'm the Early Childhood Intervention Specialist, the special education teacher here at Harrison, and I work with Mr. Greg Stormer. He's the regular education teacher. We're co-teachers, and I developed this orientation program, this video, to get you familiar with what we're going to do for the virtual learning during the COVID-19 quarantine. I just wanted to say it's a lot to digest. There's going to be a lot of information coming at you, so buckle up. If you need to take some breaks, if you need to pause it and come back to it, go ahead and do that because it's a lot of information. Last time we did virtual learning, we thought it was temporary. We thought we would be back in school. But this time, we're trying to create the best online schooling experience possible. So it's going to be a lot more rigorous than in the spring, if you were with us in the spring. So starting off, I just wanted to introduce me and Mr. Stormer. I've been teaching 17 years in Lakewood. This will be my 18th year in teaching. I got my bachelor's degree from Kent in deaf education when Lakewood had a deaf ed program, so I know sign language. I have a master's in special education curriculum instruction from Cleveland State, and I also have a second master's in educational specialist degree in advanced curriculum and instruction from Wright State. And that's me at the NAEYC conference in Tennessee this last fall. A little information about me, some fun stuff. I have two kids. Sophia's 13. Gabe is 10. They go to Berea City Schools. They're doing online learning too. There's my favorite boy, Chewbacca, Chewie, my dog. And in my spare time, I love to do Peloton and read lots of books, and cook, and I love to go shopping for makeup and jewelry. Here's Mr. Stormer. He's the early childhood education teacher. He's been teaching for 6 years in Lakewood. Previously, he was a teacher's assistant, a paraprofessional in the STARS unit at Emerson. And he received his degree from Baldwin Wallace, and he also has a degree in art from Columbus School of Art and Design. Mr. Stormer is a really awesome artist, and that's one of his murals at Emerson. He also did one at Harrison that's right when you walk in, right by the fountain. Some fun things about Mr. Stormer. He has a son named Will, who's 12. He has three dogs, Ruby, Teddy, and Ozzy. He just got Ozzy this year. He's a puppy. In his spare time, Mr. Stormer likes to mountain bike and golf and paint. And he just moved into a new house, and he has his own man cave barn. He's very excited about it. So what is an integrated preschool? An integrated preschool is a setting where children with disabilities and typically developing children are learning together. We use a standard regular education curriculum, and we tailor the lessons for each student's needs. And we provide accommodations and modifications so everybody can access the academic content and the learning environment. And an integrated preschool really is an outstanding educational model. It benefits every child. They learn their basic skills, you know, your reading, writing, and arithmetic, but they also learn things like empathy and impulse control, how to share, self-care, and how to be more independent and self-sufficient. Just a little background about UPK. You probably remember seeing all of the extra paperwork that you had to fill out for Invest in Children in UPK. So what is UPK? We are a Cuyahoga County Universal Preschool site. So through a combination of public funds from the county and private donors, specifically PNC Bank, the UPK sites are awarded grant money to improve family community resource services, curriculum assessment, and teacher professional development. And not everybody is a UPK site. You have to go through a rigorous evaluation process. You have to be a high-quality program to qualify. So we were given the grant 2 years ago based on our teacher credentials, our low student-to-teacher ratios, and our Ohio Step Up to Quality 5-star rating. If you've ever driven by a preschool or a nursery school or a daycare and it says, we're a 2-star award winner, well, we have the highest rating. We're a 5-star center, which I'm really proud of. We use our funds for tuition scholarships, family engagement activities, the Ready Rosie site, which I'm going to show you. We bought $3,000 worth of classroom supplies 2 years ago, and they sent us to the highest quality teacher training in the United States. So make sure to fill out all your forms. I know there's a lot of sensitive information that they ask for. But if you're not comfortable, you know, giving that information, that's okay. It's just that all of this data is collected by Case Western Reserve University. And it really proves that high-quality preschool improves student outcomes. Last year, they did an assessment of our kids that went on to kindergarten compared to other kids in Cuyahoga County. And about 60% of our students were right on track or above for math and language and literacy. I was especially proud that we were 5.8 points above the average, our kids in their math scores, and 3.9 points above the social emotional scores. So you can really see how our center provides really good education for our students. So our curriculum is based on the Ohio Early Learning and Development Standards. If you hover over this link, there's a hyperlink, and you can go straight to the Ohio Department of Education website to read those. But they're broken up by domain strands and skill sets by each developmental level. So we use those. That's our main curriculum. We will also be grading the kids using the Lakewood City Schools child developmental record, this little report card right here, but we're going to have to modify it due to the COVID-19 quarantine period. There's a few things here that can only be assessed in a classroom, so we'll modify that a little bit. So breaking down the standards, there's six domains. There's social emotional development, attention, behavior, emotional regulation, physical well-being and motor development, gross motor, big body movement, fine motor, little body movement like handwriting and scissoring, and self-help skills. Approaches toward learning is initiative, engagement, you know, can they set a goal, plan a goal, execute it, and their work habits. Language and literacy, letter and sound recognition, their ABCs and the sounds, concepts of print, you know, tracking print left to right, top to bottom. Phonological awareness, like rhyming and initial sounds, vocabulary. Number five, cognition and general knowledge, that's your math, social studies, and science, and cognitive skills like memory, symbolic thought, and problem solving. And I really like the standards because the grid, they have the skills for an infant, a young toddler, an older toddler, and a preschooler, so that if your child maybe is advanced or if they're a little behind, we can differentiate instruction, you know, to their individual developmental level. So here are all the assessments we do, and it's a lot, believe me. We do the DECA, the Devereux Early Childhood Assessment. It's a social, emotional, and resiliency rating scale. It will let us know which kids need more one-on-one attention, social emotional lessons about sharing and controlling their emotions. And then we have the ASQ-3, the Age of Stages questionnaire. And that's a screening tool, again, that we use. The state makes us use that. And it's a nice thing to show, you know, if they're on track for their age level, or if maybe they need a little bit more help. And if they need a lot of help, then we can refer them for special education services. So I just wanted to show you what that looks like. So the DECA, when I give it to you in your take-home packet, it looks like this. It's in Likert scale, always, sometimes, never form. You know, do they act in a way that made adults smile, listen to or respect others, control their anger, seem sad or unemotional at a happy occasion? And you'll just bubble those in, and I'll pick this up during one of my porch drop-offs. The ASQ-3, maybe some of you already filled this out, but this is the screener, and it talks about communication, yes, sometimes, not yet. Does your child name three items in a category? Can they answer questions? And it's broken down into communication, gross motor, fine motor, problem solving, personal social, and then some fill in the blank. So if you had any concerns about your child, you could put them in the fill in portion. So another assessment we do, and this is just for children on IEPs, individualized education plans, we have the Ohio Early Childhood Outcome Summary, and that's just progress monitoring to make sure that they're, fulfilling they're mastering their IEP goals. We have the report card, which I just talked about, and you'll be receiving a report card, a regular ed report card, in November and May during conferences. Children on IEPs will also receive an IEP progress report, and that's quarterly, every grading period. And then at the end of the year, we do ETRs, evaluation team reports, and that's for children on IEPs, where we do the standardized assessment to see if they still qualify for services, and that's mostly for when they move on to kindergarten. So what is your role during virtual learning? Number one, it's super important that you make sure that your child is attending virtual school every day. We're going to be taking attendance just like normal. So if for some reason you need to report an absence, I've listed the attendance line right here. You'll have to help your kid log in to Clever. That's one of the platforms we use, and hopefully they'll learn how to do it independently, but you'll probably have to assist them with that. And again, you know, it's just the nature of preschoolers. They're going to need a lot of hands-on assistance. So we appreciate you helping your child with that. The one platform I'm going to talk about is Seesaw, and make sure to use that site because children will be required to give responses, and that's through video, audio file, or work samples, and we can't really assess them if we don't have enough data on them, so make sure to upload those assignments so we can have the data. And we might even call you to ask questions about your child's progress, or say, oh, send us a quick picture of Susie's picture, or send us a quick video of Tommy writing his name, or something like that. So here we go. Online platforms and websites. Our district has purchased an online platform called Clever. And what's nice about it is, instead of students having to toggle back and forth between multiple tabs and multiple pages, Clever is one login and you have all your stuff right there. So kids don't have to continually log in, log out, you know, to a bunch of different sites. It's just one-stop shopping, all in one spot. And it has a badge login, which is nice. I'm going to print out for you QR codes. So you should be able to go to the website, hit login. Your child can take that QR code picture and put it in front of the camera, and boop, they're logged in. Same thing for Seesaw. Seesaw is the next one that we're going to post all of our lessons on there, and that's where kids will post their responses, video or pictures. We do all of our teacher-recorded lessons through YouTube. Stormer and I have our own sites. where all of our recorded lessons are posted. I purchased a weekly reader subscription. The magazine is called Let's Find Out, and the password is Harrison Pre-K 20. It's super nice because it reads the magazine aloud to kids, and there's games and activities on there. Handwriting Without Tears is our handwriting curriculum. It was developed by an occupational therapist, and it's a multi-sensory program. I really, really like this program. And there's an online website where you can watch videos. There's online handwriting activities, and there's printable worksheets. And then we have Starfall, which is our online circle time calendar. We'll do calendar and weather, and there's some literacy and math activities on there as well. So I wanted to show you some of those sites. So here we go. For Clever, here's clever.com. Here's the homepage, and you would click login as a student. Oh, shoot. It didn't work. But the dashboard looks like this. And I could post messages on here, and I have the apps you're going to use, and I'm going to post all the lessons on there. But when you go to the Clever login, when it says login as a student, it should pop up. Let's see. Nope, not that one. Yes, so see where it says Clever Badge Login? That's where you're going to use that QR code. And I'm going to print all the QR codes out for you, and it's going to look like this. So you should just be able to click on this. See where it says, once you use your camera, you'll hit allow. Hold that little QR code up to the camera, and boom, your kid's logged in. So I'm going to print those out, laminate them. So hopefully your kids will be able to do that by themselves eventually as the weeks go by. Here is Seesaw, and I've posted a sample activity where there's a little video of me, and here's how I'm talking about the data and how we collect data. It'll say add response. So I would pick pick the response. If in my instructions I said, you know, take a picture of your artwork, or show me a video of you counting 10 Cheerios. This is how you would do it from this site. And Seesaw also has a QR scan-in code if for some reason Clever wasn't working, because the technology department is having a little bit of trouble with that right now. So hopefully Clever works. If not, we can log into Seesaw manually with the QR code. And this is a sample. I'll print this out. So you can, you know, type it in to access the Seesaw account, or there's that QR code, and you could scan it just like Clever. Here is my YouTube site that I'm very proud of, and I'll have all of my video uploads on there. That's from spring. Here's Mr. Stormer's site right there. And then here's the Let's Find Out. So if you were to hit login and click I am a student, why isn't it working? Come on. Anyway, you should be able to do that. Click I am a student and punch in Harrison Pre-K 20, and it will take you to all of the cool things. But why isn't it working right now? Arg! Come on, let's find out what's going on here. There we go. Oh, And there it is. Okay. So there are all the issues for September 2020. And you can click on those. And there's little videos. And there's the games. Some of the games are a little bit too hard for preschoolers. But some of them are good. Like this one's a sorting small, medium, and large apples. But if you click on this,
Little Green Apple. A little green apple grows on a tree. How did it get from the farm to me? Let's follow that apple.
So see how it reads it aloud to you? Love, love, love Weekly Reader. I had it when I was a child, and it's an excellent resource. And then I wanted to talk about Handwriting Without Tears. And they have a bit bigger program called Learning Without Tears. So you're going to go to lwtears.com/GSS for Get Set for School. And you're going to go down to the distance learning, I believe. Yeah. And you'll have to create a login, I think. Yeah, create a free account. And so once you do that, you'll be able to access the resources. And this little play button shows the resources right here. And you'd click on resources, and then they have all different kinds of things. Here's a video.
Capital A.
About how to
form. Smiley face helps you get started. Let's go! Whoa. Cool! Start at the top. In the center. Big line slides down. Big line slides down. Little line across the middle. Later, alligator.
And then it has letter formations. And let's see what else. You could do numbers, uppercase, lowercase. Okay. And then we have Starfall. So if you go to starfall.com, hit kindergarten and pre-K. Right here, we have all kinds of fun games to learn the alphabet.
A. A.
And we'll be using this calendar for,
Yippee! It's August 2020. Let's make a calendar. Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. Goodbye.
Okay. So you get the idea. Let's go back to the presentation here. So we will be using Zoom for our face-to-face lessons. It's an audio and web conferencing platform. A lot of you guys are probably already using it for work. It's like FaceTime or Facebook Messenger video chat. You can download the app on your computer or phone, and we'll send you a link through email, probably, or the Remind app. And you'll select Join with Video, and you just have to make sure that you're giving Zoom permission to use your web camera and your microphone so you're not muted and we can see you and everything. So here's what a Zoom invite is going to look like. going to look like this. When I send you a Zoom invite, it'll say join Zoom meeting, and you just click on that and say join with video, and it should work. And make sure there's a little microphone icon, and you just click on that to make sure it's not muted. But that's what we're going to use for our face-to-face lessons. Okay, so here is the general overview. I'm going to skip ahead. So Mondays, the Beck Center for the Arts provides excellent arts education for us, music classes and art classes. So Mondays are going to be all Beck Center. 9:45 to 10:15 and 10:30 to 11 is art. In the afternoon, it's 12:30 to 1 and then arts 1:30 to 2. And then I'm going to do my small group Zoom on Mondays. Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, it's going to be broken down into literacy and math. So you're going to watch a 15-minute video that we recorded on YouTube, and then we'll do a Zoom lesson from 9:15 to 9:30. And then we'll do the same thing with math. 15 minutes of watching a video, and then 15 minutes of a Zoom lesson. Following that, if your child's on an IEP and they have OT services, that they'll receive occupational therapy. Wednesday, same thing, literacy and math, and then speech therapy. Thursday, literacy and math, and then physical therapy. And then on Fridays, we're going to do social-emotional lessons about sharing and taking turns and being nice and being kind. Again, a 15-minute video and a 15-minute Zoom lesson. We use a program called Second Step, which uses a lot of pictures and role play. And then we'll do some science and social studies videos for 15 minutes and then a Zoom lesson for 15 minutes. And then afterwards, there will be one-on-one instruction with me, which I'll rotate students out, and then small group instruction with Mr. Stormer. Now, this is just, you know, this is the schedule, but it's subject to change at any time. You know, we have to factor in our kiddos and their attention spans and how long they can go. If we see that, you know, they're getting antsy and they're not paying attention, we'll try to do a music and movement activity. But sometimes we might need to scrap it. Sometimes we might need to modify the lesson. So we're going to just go with this for now, and hopefully it works. So we have a lot of supports for you. Every month you'll be receiving a newsletter with parent education articles, and it gives an overview of like the themes for the week and what we're doing. You'll be getting bi-weekly homework packets delivered to your porch or mailbox. Those are little worksheets that you could do with your kids, and don't try to do them all in one sitting. You know, try to break it up, like do a half a page and another half a page, and do it over the course of 2 weeks. And then we have this awesome site called Ready Rosie that gives you little quick, easy ideas for things you could do at home with just things you have at home. And the activities are only like 2 or 3 minutes. So I love this site. It's wonderful. UPK funds pay for that. We also use Remind, and you should have received an invitation from me for Remind. And Remind, you have to have Remind. This is the one thing that you've got to have, because we use this to text parents about announcements, about changes. We send out the YouTube videos. Like, we always use Remind. So please accept the invitation. And if you deleted the invitation, what you could do is go to Remind or download the app on your phone and then put in this code, and you'll automatically be included in our classroom Remind. You could always contact us through email. That's the easiest way. We check our email a million times a day, so that's a quick, easy way to get a hold of us. If you need to hold an individual Zoom meeting with us, if you're concerned about something or you need help or just anything, just request it. Just shoot us an email and say, hey, can we do an individual Zoom meeting? And then every day after instruction, we'll have office hours, so you can always text us through Remind or email us or call us. So I wanted to show you the Ready Rosie site, which is right here. And so you'll, in your email or, you know, through text, you'll click this link and this is what your playlist will look like. And so you can click on these little videos, and these are real families doing activities at home. And let me pick one. Play. Here we go.
Royce, come here, baby. Hey, I'm finishing up laundry and I need your help, okay? Fit all these socks here. Let's count them up.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19.
So we're going to put these socks together. What's that called when you put socks together?
A pair.
A pair. Let's make pairs of socks so you can help me out. How many pairs do you think we have in here?
Let me think.
If you had to take a guess, what do you think? Like...
Okay. So that's an example of Ready Rosie, and I'll be sending you little videos each week for activities you could do at home. And then the Remind app, if you go to Google Play or App Store, download it for free, and what you'll see here is what it would look like on your phone. And you can message us individually, you can send out a group message, you can set up play dates with families, but the messages will look like this, just like a text. And it's super important to have Remind on your phone because things change so often that this is a vital resource. You have to have this. So getting back to the presentation. This Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, so the 2nd, 3rd, 4th, we're going to have Supply Baggy Pickup. And that's going to be at 2080 Quail Street. That's Harrison Elementary. And on the side of Harrison, you'll see a big open courtyard with our school garden. And that's where Mr. Stormer will be, and that's where I will be. And we have some things for you guys to pick up. So we're going to have a welcome bag. It'll have the parent handbook and some things like a few pencils, crayons, fun things like a punch balloon for the kids. There's also going to be student materials baggie where we're going to give them a wipe-off board, a marker and eraser, a mini chalkboard slate with chalk, eraser, and sponge. Those are going to be for that Handwriting Without Tears program. A 10 frame, which is just 10 boxes, and these are little eraser counters so we can teach them how to count and concepts of 5 and 10 and a number line, counting forward and backward on a number line. We will also have a take-home folder. I'm going to put those questionnaires in there and a Step Up to Quality family information form that we need for your permanent file. And we'll pick those questionnaires and things up from your house the next time we do porch drop-off for homework. We'll also include any overdue or missing registration paperwork, like medical forms. I'll put the newsletter in there and the Clever and Seesaw QR code badges. So I sent out a sign-up genius for you to sign up for a time for that. Mr. Stormer has been calling families, so if he has not contacted you, make sure you send him an email. So here are some things that you can have at home that would be really helpful if you had at home during virtual learning time. Crayons, markers, and colored pencils. Crayola, definitely recommended. The other brands are too waxy. The pencils break. The crayons fall apart. Crayola, definitely recommended. Number two, pencils. Ticonderoga is a good brand because the wood doesn't flake off, and it's just a good quality pencil. A pencil sharpener. Lots and lots of blank paper. I would just go to Target or Walmart and pick up a pack of printer paper, you know, just blank white printer paper. Construction paper, kids' scissors, glue sticks, a can of Play-Doh. We will include a can of Play-Doh in the welcome packet. Little things like pennies, Cheerios, or dried pasta so they can count. And a watercolor set would be nice. Definitely Crayola also, because the other brands are just too cheap and they don't have a good pigment in them, and it makes the paper flake up. So in terms of devices and internet access, your child will need an iPad or a tablet, or a laptop or a desktop. And if they have those, they're good to go. Your browser, you'll need either Chrome or Firefox. Mobile devices will work, but they aren't going to work well. The screen is so small and there's so much to click, and your child won't have access to the full classroom experience if you just have a mobile device. So, and also Kindles do not work. Kindle will not work. So if you need a device, or if you need assistance with getting Wi-Fi, I've included the number for our technology department, 529-4088, and hopefully you'll be able to go in there or at Harrison and pick up a device. They've purchased iPads for all preschool students. And we just wanted you to know that we understand what a challenging time this is, having to do school online instead of in person. We miss you guys, and we really wish we were back in the classroom. But until it's safe for staff and students to go back to buildings, we're really committed to providing your children with the best preschool experience possible. You're not going to get this level of education anywhere else. And since virtual instruction is kind of new to us, a lot of these platforms are new to us. The district just purchased them. Just know that schedules may change. You know, we might have technology hiccups, but we'll problem solve. And if we can all be flexible and adapt, we can do this together. And we truly appreciate all your help and support. I mean, we wouldn't be able to do this without parents helping in the learning process. And if you have technology problems, if you need a walkthrough, if you're struggling with food or, you know, paying utilities or basic things like that, anything, don't hesitate to reach out to us. We have a lot of resources through the UPK program, and we can get you help. We're here for you guys in any way you need. So, our district slogan is One Heartbeat, One Lakewood, and we're really excited about working with your children this year. Any questions, just give us a call. All right. We'll see you September 8th for the first day of instruction. Bye.